Hey there, guys, it's Tina and I'm back. And I am feeling so summery and fun right now. It is almost 90 degrees outside. It is actually 90 degrees. I went out earlier today and I just immediately started sweating. It was a whole situation. But here's the thing, all right? I am doing a simple summer glam look for you guys. And I know that sweating isn't necessarily glamorous, but hey, if we're gonna sweat and be out in the heat, why can't we look fancy while we're doing it? So I'm gonna show you guys how to accomplish this beautiful bronzy, bright lip, neutral eye summer look, which I think is really glamorous and beautiful. And of course, I am using some glamorous fancy brands today. We have Dior, Yves Saint Laurent, Victoria Beckham. We're doing it, okay? We're having fun with makeup. And this look was actually requested by one of you guys. So in my recent videos, I've been wearing like a subtle neutral eye with a little bit of smoky outer V, a beautiful bright summer lip and bronzy skin. And you asked me to go ahead and share how I accomplished that look because you guys are into more neutral looks. And I definitely like to mix in neutral looks with my bright, bold, colorful looks because you guys know I love color, but I also love neutral and I love doing these simple looks, especially when I'm going out and just hanging out. I don't necessarily want to go with color all the time, so I definitely understand mixing in more neutral tutorials and get ready with me videos for you guys to actually use as your inspiration. And maybe you can even pick up some tips and techniques. So if you want to see how I accomplish this subtle neutral eye and bold lip, but very bronzy glam skin, then stay tuned and I will talk to you soon. All right, guys, so as usual, we're starting off with a clean, freshly washed face. And I filled in my brows and applied just a bit of concealer under the brows just to keep that shape nice and crisp. And now I'm going to go in with some moisturizer. Look how tiny and cute this is. This is from La Mer. It's the moisturizing gel cream. And I got a little sample of it. It is so adorable. So I'm gonna grab some of that and apply it to my skin. I have a pimple right here, but it won't pop. I know, I shouldn't be popping pimples. I pop my pimples, okay, because I need to get rid of the evil that's in them for them to actually heal, and that's just something I've learned from my skin. I need to pop my pimples. Sorry, it is what it is. I do use my pimple patches and I use like my acne solution to help them heal. Like if they aren't the poppable ones, I know it's kind of gross, but if they aren't the poppable ones, then I'll use a little bit of acne treatment on them and that will speed up the healing. And I find that if I pop it and then put the treatment on it, it will heal next day. I know, TMI, but here we are, okay? I'm talking about getting glam and this is what I come at you with. Well, I just used La Mer, so that should kind of offset it. Maybe, I don't know. Okay, just work with me, all right? So now that I've confirmed how not glamorous I am, let's go ahead and do a very simple glam eyeshadow look. So we're gonna go in with a Dior eyeshadow palette, actually two of them, but I'm gonna go in with this one. This is the Dior Backstage Eye Palette in 001 Warm Neutrals. And there are warmer neutral shades in this palette, as you can see. I'm gonna start out with the primer shade. I haven't used this yet, so I wanna see how it works. And I'm just grabbing that on my Anissa Beauty Angled Concealer Brush. This is a very light beige cream, so I'm not applying too much, even though it doesn't allow me to apply too much. And I'm just gonna blend that right across the lid. I don't like having this cream in the powder eyeshadow palette because the powders kick up and get into it, so it's not the most ideal, but let's try it out anyway and see how it applies. It's not very creamy, it's not really emollient. It's a drier formula, like a cream to powder, which is actually better for an eyeshadow primer, so it should stand a better chance of not creasing throughout wear, but we'll see how that goes. I'm gonna start out with a mix of this shade, which is the Sculpting Powder, and then the matte nude shade here. And I'm just mixing those together on my Sonia G Detail Pro Brush, and that's gonna be our transition shade in the crease. So I'm just gonna give myself a wash of color right there in the crease line. And we're just doing light windshield wiper motions to get that color deposited. That's actually blending and applying pretty nicely. I'm gonna pick up a little bit more of the lighter nude shade. So the light beigey shade and blend that on that outer V area. And that's gonna give a lighter effect so it's not as shadowy. So next I'm going in with this orangey brown, which is called Ochre. And I'm going to apply that mainly in the outer crease. So not really on the outer V just yet. I'm using this as a crease shade and that's gonna add warmth. And like I said, because I applied the matte beige, it's gonna help to blend out the edge. So this color won't apply as intensely. It's just gonna give a wash of warmth, which is what I'm going for. And I'm applying that with a number 5 blending brush from BH Cosmetics, which is a smaller blending brush. So that's going to allow me a little bit more precision with this application. Even though I'm like blending it all the way over, it's still allowing me to get right into that crease line. And we're gonna blow out the warm color right up to the brow bone. All right, so I'm going in with a second Dior Backstage Eye Palette. This is 003 Amber Neutrals. So this has some more warm tones and a couple of cranberry shades. And I'm gonna grab the matte red shade. And I'm just grabbing a very little touch of that because I know this is pigmented. As much as you might not expect Dior to have pigmented eyeshadows, it's very pigmented and I don't want like a serious red shade. I just want to add a little bit of warmth. You see, look how intense that is, and I already have shadows down, so it shouldn't even be as intense, but that's gonna warm up the crease just a little bit, and I'm using the same small blending brush so we can get precision on that outer crease and outer V. That is such a stunning red shade. Like, who would have thought that Dior had it going on with the pigmentation, right? But I've been loving these palettes. I've used them a couple of times, and they work really well. They blend really effortlessly. The shades are nicely pigmented. Like, I'm not struggling for color payoff. And they're just seamless. Like, look at that. All right, now from the same Amber Neutrals palette, I'm going to grab some of the Brick shade here, which is a matte, like, orangey deep brown. But I'm also going to mix in a little bit of the Sculpting powder. And again, I'm grabbing that on the same smaller blending brush, and we're gonna apply that on the outer V area. This is where we're gonna pull down the depth and build dimension. And mixing the two shades together will give me a deep, kind of warm brown, which is what I'm going for. So you see how the red is still popping out, but now we have this deeper red brown. It's absolutely stunning, and look at the pigmentation again. It's so easy to get color payoff from these. I don't have to do much, and they just apply, and look how easily they're applying and blending. I'm really impressed. Like, I didn't know what to expect with Dior eyeshadows. I was like, are they gonna be great? But I feel like their Backstage line is really, really amazing. And these shadows blend so well. Look at that. That was a lot. I probably didn't need to add the wink there, but I was feeling a little saucy, okay? Now, let's go in with a deep brown. So this is Smoky Brown from the Amber Neutrals palette. And I'm gonna be very, very careful with this. I'm going in with a classic crease brush from Sonia G and just popping that on the outer V. Like, I picked up just a little bit and look how intensely that is picking up. This is what I'm saying, like, these shadows are quite impressive. So just popping that on the outer V to create depth and dimension. And this is a more pointed crease brush, so it's gonna allow me a lot of precision. And look, it's so pretty, like the blend that I can get. And I'm gonna go back in with the small blending brush just to go around the edges. And this one has some of that warmer brown mix that we started out with. And like, come on now. I know I'm decent at blending. Like, I'm not a beginner anymore. I'm more of a advanced novice. Like, I'm not an expert, but I'm definitely a solid novice. But look how, like, I'ma come in. Y'all look at this. Look at the blend. Look at the blend. You can't look. Look, this eye's a little tricky because it's a different shape. But this one, Right? My eyes have two different shapes, okay? And most of us have different shaped eyes, but this one is my preferred one just because it has like a defined shape to it. Like I have a definite lid and a crease and stuff. This one, I have to just match up to this one as best as I can because this is slightly hooded. Do you see? Y'all see this, right? You can't unsee it now that I've shown you, right? This is slightly hooded, so I have less crease area, so I have to just kind of make sure that this one kind of matches with this one by opening my eyes and seeing where everything lands. And, you know, I do my best, okay? I do my best. So I'm going to grab the bronze highlighter shade, and I'm grabbing that on a Sonia G Worker 2 brush. Now, the shimmers may be where people have the biggest complaints because the shimmers are very subtle. They're more like satin shades rather than shimmers. They're not really frosty or metallic. They're simple, easy shimmers that you can just pop on the lid and go. They add a glow, but they're not gonna give you sparkle and shine. And I know a lot of people are into that. I can go both ways. Sometimes I just want a subtle sheen on my lids, kind of like this. And then sometimes I want really metallic, frosty sheen. And I think for a subtle, like glam look, a subtle sheen is better than a high metallic shine. So I really like this shade. So I'm just gonna blend that all over the lid. And it blends in really well with the mattes because it's not too frosty. So you're not gonna see a harsh separation between shimmer and matte. Now I can be a little sassy with these. So I'm gonna dampen my brush a little bit and show you how these pick up when they're used with a damp brush. And I'm gonna go back into the Warm Neutrals palette and grab their highlighter shade. I wonder if you guys can hear the birds chirping like in my background. These birds are living their best life and I love hearing them, except when it's really early morning and I'm trying to sleep and they're out here just chirping up a storm. I'm like, listen, it's 4 o'clock. Could y'all go back to bed and just wait to mate? Because I can't right now. I'm trying to sleep. So you see, it picks up, it's a little bit brighter, it's a little bit more like intense, but it's still not like a high frosty shade. It's not gonna give you metallic in your face, and I really like that about these shades. So I'm just gonna blend that out on the edges, and I'll pull a little bit of that to the inner tear duct. I don't think I'm gonna go in with a separate inner tear duct highlight because I wanna keep this very simple, very soft, and I already went in and made it really metallic. I'm gonna go back into the Amber Neutrals and let's pick up a little bit of all of these shades, these matte shades. I just mix them all on the brush and I'll go back into the outer V and outer crease just to blend the edge of the shimmer, just to make sure that matte wasn't covered up at all. All right, I'm not gonna do much else, but I will go back into the Warm Neutrals and grab the matte beige shade and pop it on my brow bone, and that's gonna be our highlight. And that is just easy. You pull it down so it blends out a little bit of the edge of the crease color so it doesn't go as high. And that's it. All right, let's work on the face. All right, so I don't want to do anything too crazy heavy on my face, so I'm going in with a tinted product. I'm going to use the Fenty Beauty Eavesdrop Blurring Skin Tint. And I feel like for soft glam looks, you shouldn't go full coverage. Go for something lightweight. You can always go in with concealer if you need more coverage. Oh, that's what I forgot. All right, let me go in with my corrector. One step before we go in with the skin tint. So I have the Bright Fix Eye Brightener. This is in the shade Pumpkin. I'm not gonna use it for my eyes. I'm gonna actually use it around my mouth to cover up some of that darkness. I've been using this for these areas and it's been working really well. You can also use it on old acne scars, and I'm gonna put it on my pimple. All right, that may look a little crazy, but listen, you blend it out. It's a very lightweight product, so it's not gonna be too heavy on the skin. And it blends out pretty easily. It's very pigmented though. This pumpkin shade, whoo, it's heavy duty for real, for real. So if you're darker skin tone and you have like areas that you want to color correct, this is a great shade. But it also works on my skin tone, you know? I just have to make sure that I blend my tinted product over it pretty well. So going back in with the skin tint now. And you see it covers it pretty well, even though it's a lightly tinted product. So I don't worry about the orange peeking through too much, but it does help to color correct, definitely. I love that. And this skin tint is very lightweight. Oh, the shade I use is number 17, didn't mention that before. And I think it's such a great match. I've been using it the majority of the time that I apply foundation at all, because it is so lightweight and it's getting warmer, so I don't want anything heavy on my skin. If I want more full coverage, I'll go in with my Clinique Even Better Serum Foundation. That is more full coverage, but it still feels pretty lightweight, so it's not heavy duty either. But this one definitely feels a lot lighter on the skin. So let's go over, my pimple. My pimple hurts so bad. It hurts so bad. It's just been sitting there chilling, giving me a hard time, and I'm so upset because it hurts. If I frown, it hurts. If I raise my eyebrows, it hurts. If I touch it, it hurts. I'm just over it, okay? I'ma need it to go ahead and get out of here because it's not fun at all. All right, so skin done. Perfect, beautiful. And now we can go in with under eye concealer, because that I can't do without, because child, these under eyes, woo! And I pull my concealer all the way under my eyes and over to my cheekbone, because my foundation doesn't cling right here. For whatever reason, I don't know, but my concealer will cling over there, which is what I need, right? Because you'll just see foundation and then like a blotchy spot here, and I'm like, what is that? That's not even cute. And I realized my foundation, for whatever reason, doesn't always cling to this area, and I don't know what is happening to that side of my skin, but the concealer will cover it just fine. So I just blend my concealer all the way over there, even though I know the new way is to put a dot and like do it really lightweight. Listen, I use a concealer shade that is my skin tone, so it's not like I'm adding a brightening effect, so it's not gonna be too extra if I pull it all the way out. And that, I think, is why people are doing less and less concealer, because they typically would use a lighter concealer under the eyes, and so when you pull it all the way out, then it looks like you have this raccoon, like reverse raccoon effect, and that's not what I do anyway, so it doesn't matter. All right, there we go. Do we want to go in with the under eye brightener, or we're good? I think we're good. We're good here. Yes, we're good. We're still going to set with powder though, and I'm using my Kosas Cloud Set powder. This is so nice. This is in the shade Pillowy. It's a baked powder. It's very lightweight. So it blurs my skin, mattifies, but it's not heavy at all. And I'm also going to pull that up under my eyes. I'll go in with a smaller powder brush just to... Did I blend any product on the top of my lip? I keep forgetting to do... Whatever, it doesn't matter. The point is, all right, this powder, very lightweight, very comfortable, but it sets my skin down and it doesn't mattify. Well, it kind of mattifies, but it's not like a dry matte. Not what you would think of when you say matte, you know? It really just makes my skin look nice and airbrushed. But it doesn't look completely like, well, it does look matte right now, but it's blurred, like perfected. Do you guys see? Do you see? Right? Okay. All right, now let's go in with a glamorous bronzer. So this is from Victoria Beckham Beauty. It is the Bronzing Brick in shade number 4. I did a full video of this. I will link it over here so you can check it out. Love this bronzer so much. So, okay, let me start up. No, let me go in. I'm gonna go between the two shades, and I'm using an Anissa Beauty Multi Powder Brush, and I'm just gonna apply that to my hairline area to give a soft brush. Look at that. It just gives this beautiful warmth to my skin without being too intense, and it blends so easily. Like, I just added a... I can't say enough. This is so stunning. I'll go in and sculpt a little bit with the deeper shade, which is the Sculpt shade. And I'm using my sculpting brush from Anissa Beauty as well. And I'll just apply that to the hollow of my cheek, a little bit on my jawline. My jawline. Blend it out. Look, y'all, I'm sorry. Y'all need to go ahead and check this out, okay? I've heard some mixed reviews. I heard someone say they didn't like the packaging because it doesn't stay closed, but I've never had an issue with it. I think the packaging is quite sleek and sexy, and the powders work beautifully for me. And I wouldn't use the lighter shade as a bronzer by itself. I feel like I do have to mix the two, but the contour shade, come on bronzer. And I'll do a little bit of bronzing on my little chin here, my little double chin and my jawline, just to make sure everything looks like it flows together. Oh yes, and this brush works so beautifully with these bronzer products. Come on now. All right, let me do mascara, which isn't a big like fancy thing. Just pop that on. This is from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It is my favorite mascara, okay? I'm gonna give Norvina and Anastasia their due. This mascara though, loving it. It's so similar to the Too Faced Better Than Sex, but it doesn't flake. So it's like perfect. I found my perfect replacement. Gives me volume and richness to my lashes. Okay, but it doesn't flake. So I am loving that. So I'm just gonna apply that to my lashes. And we're gonna actually pop on some false eyelashes in a second as well. All right, so while the glue on my lashes is drying, I'm gonna go in with a little bit of lower waterline liner. I'm using the Master Pigment Pro Pencil from Makeup by Mario in the shade Deep Plum. And I'm just gonna apply that on the outer lower waterline. I'm not going all the way in because I don't wanna close off the eyes. I just want a little depth and smokiness on that outer lash line. And I did go in with my lower lash mascara, which is the one I always use. This is from MAC. It's the Extended Play Giga Black Lash Mascara. Absolutely love that. And the lashes I'm going in with are from Kiss. They're the Lash Couture Luxtensions Collection in the style Royal Silk. These are really beautiful. I've been loving these lashes. They're definitely among my favorite lashes I've ever used of all time. They are stunning, easy to pop on, and they are available at the drugstore, so you can get them on a sale. I think this specific style is like $5.99 or maybe $7.99, but again, you can always get them on sale. There's always a discount, plus you can use coupons. And they are reusable multiple times, because I have reused my pairs a few times already, and I just get rid of them when they get a little bit gunky and I can't be bothered anymore, and I just pop out a new pair. But like I said, you can get them on sale. They are look, right? They're not too loud or in your face. They're really subtle, but they just add the drama to the lash line. But they're not, you know what I'm saying? They're not like, oh, I'm gonna fly away. And you can tell I'm wearing lashes, but they don't look too pronounced. So those are the lashes popped on. All right, for the cheeks, I'm going to go in with something very subtle because I low-key like this just bronzer look, but I'm going to go in with a natural blush. So this is from Charlotte Tilbury. It's the Cheek to Chic Swish and Glow Blusher in Pillow Talk Intense. So there's a lighter version and a deeper version. This one is the Intense, and I'm gonna go right between the two shades, picking up a little bit of the shimmer shade that's in the middle, the nipple. And I'm going in with just a small blush brush to apply that to the cheek area. It's a very subtle neutral, almost like a brownie. Yeah, it's like a brownie tan shade with a little hint of a purpley tone to it, which can be very, very questionable on my skin tone. This can come off way too bruisey, but I think in this case, it's given me more of a nudie tan glow to my cheeks. And I'm just gonna blend that out. So you see, it gives that natural look to my cheek. I'll bring it up just a little bit right here. I think I actually should have gone in with a little bit. Yeah, because this side looks better. So I'm gonna grab the bronzer because I think I missed a spot on this side. So I'm just gonna grab a little and pop it right, yeah, right there. And that's gonna help to blend out the blush as well. Okay, now you can see just a subtle blush. Again, very glam, very easy, nothing too poppy, like nothing too pink. And then I'll go in with this highlighter that I've fallen in love with. It's an all-over glow powder, but on me, it's a highlighter, okay? I don't like a really in-your-face highlighter, so for me, this is a highlighter. So this is from Yves Saint Laurent. It's the Touche Éclat 3D All-Over Glow. And it's just one shade. It's a universal shade. It's like a pinky gold, and I'm just going to apply that to the tops of my cheeks. So you see it's very light, not like light colored, but it's a very light powder. So it's not intense, it's not shimmery, it's not glittery, it just gives a glow. So you can use it all over the face. I choose not to because no, but I like it on the cheeks for that just very subtle, beautiful, soft glow. I think that is absolutely stunning. I'm gonna go ahead and pop on my outfit and then we'll come back and finish up with the lip color. All right, guys, so I am back and, you know, I'm rocking the off the shoulder because that's what I do in the summertime. That's like my go-to. Now, looking at my face with this outfit on, I feel like I need a little bit more color on the cheeks. So I'm going in with one of my Lawless blushes. This is Make Me Blush Velvet Blush in the shade Angel Suede. And this is still a nudie tone, but it has a little bit of peach to it. So it's not gonna change too much as far as color on my face. It's just gonna give a little color, but like not too much. And I love the finish of these blushes. So just a little something, nothing too much. And then for the lips, we're gonna go bold and glam because I think color is just it for the summertime. So this is from Gucci. This is one of their matte lipsticks. I'm going in with Cassie Magenta. And on my lips, this is more of a bright magenta shade. And I'm going to outline the edges of my lips. So I'll go around the complete perimeter of my lips with this shade. I absolutely love it. And then on the center of my lips, I'm going in with a second shade. This is the shade Vantine Fuchsia. This is a little bit lighter of a fuchsia shade, but they're very similar. So they blend together beautifully to give me this bright fuchsia lip. And I absolutely love this lipstick. I love this look. So here you have it, guys. This is the final look. So this is how I do simple glam. Simple, easy, a beautiful neutral eye. It's very easy to accomplish. You can pull out any of your neutral palettes and accomplish the same thing. At least if it's like a warm neutral palette, you can accomplish a very simple, subtle, easy look like this and then just pair it with a bold lip. And these Gucci lipsticks have just been my jam. And the skin is very simple, very subtle, but at the same time, it's a beautiful glam bronzy look. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, enjoyed this get ready with me. I am headed out to hang out with my family. Everybody is vaccinated, so it's gonna be a good time. We're gonna hang out and chill and have some food. So I'll probably have to take this off and do a nudie lip. Maybe, maybe not, because I really love this color. I'll think about it. I'll bring something to just wipe this off in case I need to. Where is my earring? None of y'all were gonna tell me that I was missing an earring. Listen, okay, I don't trust that. Y'all are sabotaging me. All right, there we go. Now this is the final look. So again, hopefully you guys enjoyed this get ready with me video featuring this beautiful summer glam look. To me, it's a very simple look. It's a very effective look because it's beautiful. It looks sexy and glamorous, but it's not too overstated. I think it's still very subtle, very understated, but gorgeous at the same time. So let me know what you guys think, and let me know if you try out any of these products or if you try this look out for yourself using products that you already have in your collection. Let me know how it goes. What do you think of the techniques? And if there are any other looks that you want me to do, just leave them in the comments down below and we will see if we can get to them. But hopefully again you enjoyed the video. I will leave a full list of all the products used and mentioned down below in the description box, along with links on where you can pick them up. If there's an asterisk next to any of those links, that means that they're affiliate links, which means I will make a small sales commission if you make a purchase through those links. No pressure though, but it's a great way to support the channel without doing much else. So if you're going to buy something, consider shopping through my links, because it does help me to put right back into the channel. So I truly do appreciate your support. But again, if you're not comfortable with that, just shop the way you normally shop, no muss, no fuss. I'm still happy you're here watching and supporting. If you want to show your support in other ways, go ahead, hit the thumbs up button, share with your friends, favorite, add to a playlist, leave a comment, you know, just say hey, hi, how you doing? Anything that you do to show your support is really appreciated. And you can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter, you know, where we have some fun over there. And until my next video, which will be very soon, I'll talk to you. Bye, guys.